What's up, YouTubers? It's Keith here making another video, guys. Hope everybody's doing well. I'm downstairs in the downstairs bathroom of my house trying to make a quick video, you guys. I know it's been a while since I made one, but I want to make a quick video, you guys, covering something that I got a PM request from a good buddy of mine, Danny. I want to say what's up to you, buddy. He asked if I knew how to make those, they're called the Shemagh, but when I was in the service, a lot of the Joes called them Haji head wraps. I know that's not politically correct, but that's what some of the guys called them. But and I'm gonna show you what they look like. This is what they look like. Maybe you've seen them. They're becoming more and more popular as a trendy urban fashion statement. But they're worn and adorned by people all over the world. People just think just people in the Middle East wear these, but they're not. People say they're from Palestine, but people wear these all over, you guys. It's called a Shemagh. The real ones are anywhere between 40 to 42 inches wide, so they're very big. The real ones are large. I got this, I have a couple of them, but this one I got while I was overseas in Iraq. I bought it at a bazaar, so it's probably from China. But anyways, nevertheless, this is a real one. And as you can see, it's pretty large. And what you do is I'm utilizing the mirror behind me, you guys, to help. You see it's pretty large. What you do is fold it in a triangle, which is, you know, a triangle. Very Illuminati, right? But anyways, you fold it in the triangle. And then what you do is, you take 3/4 of it. Let me see if I can do this. You take about 3/4 of it, you guys. So like, as you can see, that's probably about 3/4 right there. You fold it down over your eyebrows. Take the corner of it, fold it, and you wrap it under your chin and make it cross right on your earlobe, right on your ear canal. Where would it be? So you make sure you cross it right there. Then you take it, and the reason why, because it'll make it nice and even. Then you bring it across your mouth and around your head. You take your tag end, and you do a quick overhand knot. And you cinch it down. And you could even tuck this in, and tuck it in there. And then you just adjust it to however you need, and you bring this around. Now what this does, you guys, if you do it the right way, it'll cover the back of your neck, the front of your neck, your mouth, and your eyes. Now this, like I said, you guys, this is worn by people from the Himalayas to Saudi Arabia to Iraq, Afghanistan, Pakistan, sheep herders and all that jazz. But what it does is it protects your face from being weather beaten from the elements of the weather, whether it be sun, because it's keeping it covered. And if you do it right, this leaves like a brim. If you can see from the side, it leaves a brim or a rim like a hat, so it covers you, it shades your eyes from the sun. Also, it does protect your head and your face and mouth from the sand, sun, reflection. Even if you're in a snowy condition, the bright white can actually sunburn your face and your eyes. So this covers your face and your eyes. And like I said, if you do it correctly, you'll cover your back, the back of your neck and your face. Now what you could do, this will protect your eyes from, like I said, from the sun and your mouth. And when you speak to like elders, they have to see your mouth when you talk. So you'd fold it down like this to speak to elders or to eat. And then you can also pull this down like this over your neck, and it keeps your neck covered. And this is another way to wear. Like I said, you guys, these are multi-use item right here, because they are large. You can open them out, get some cordage, 550 cord, bank line, whatever, and string it up and keep it as overhead shade protection. If you're in a very sunny desert element, you can use this to filter water because it's cloth, but it's extremely breathable, so you can use it to filter water. You can use this as a tourniquet. You can use it as a emergency sling for a busted arm. You can use it to cinch down material. You guys, it's multi-use. And it actually is see-through. You can actually, if it's up on your face, you can actually see through it. So it's kind of transparent. So if, like I said, if the wind's blowing or whatnot, you can actually see through it. You can, like I said, you can gather wet grass or moss, put it in here, and just twist, and out comes water. You can use it for that, you guys. Another way of wrapping it is you take a tag end like this, put it over your shoulder. Let me see how I can do this. Like this. Then you come around like this to the front. Then you go back around your head and you tie it, you cinch it down under. Fold it back down, cover your knotting, and there you go. And then you have a neck wrap, you know. But this has been popular, you guys, from all the kids playing, you know, all these combat games all these video games, and this became popular, you guys, what, at the beginning of the early 2000s, when photographs of Special Forces units were shown wearing these. Now, this has been worn and adorned by members of the U.S. Special Forces and the British Commandos and SAS out in desert conditions and stuff like that, you guys. So it made it popular. People buy these and they think they're freaking Commandos or Green Berets. It's ridiculous. They have all their tactical gear and paintball gear, and they're like, you know, they think they're some elitist. But anyways, like I said, I'll do it real quick again, you guys, so I can show you how to do the proper head wrap. It's my daughter. Hold on, baby. You take it, you do 3/4. Hold on, baby. Come over your eyebrows, fold it, come up over your chin, across in your ear, come around your face and mouth, meeting up the tag ends, and do an overhand knot like this and tuck it in. And that protects you from the sun, from whether it's bright sun, snow that you're crossing, or the desert. Protects you from sandstorms, because if you've ever been in a sandstorm, it's you know, it's unbearing. And your eyes, you want to keep it low as possible. Okay, you can get these in different colors. People say, oh, well, this color means pro-Palestine and this color means that. Well, you know, whatever. I'm not looking into it that much, okay, like some of you guys. But just wanted to show this to you guys. It is called a Shemagh. People call them Haji head wraps. Like I said, they made it popular by the Special Forces units in theater of operation. But it is a good and useful item to throw in your bug out bags or emergency gears, because it's extremely collapsible, you guys. And as you can see, I don't know if you guys can see, but it's huge. It's huge. You take this and you can string it up and it provides shade, like I said. And you can see it is see-through. Oh. But anyways. Okay. So I just wanted to get this to show you guys out there. Okay, baby, I'll be right out. So you guys, pick one of these up. You can find them at anywhere from Army Surplus stores or Amazon, eBay. They're fairly cheap, but make sure you get the real one. The real ones are large. They're very large. Like I said, I think they're like 42 inches or something like that, 40, 42 inches. But that's the proper way, you guys. If you do it the right way to cover if you wrap the Shemagh, it will cover your neck, the front and the back, and protect your eyes and stuff like that. You can use this as an emergency backpack, throw your gear over it. I don't have the stuff to show you right now. and you wrap it like this, and it becomes a carrying device for your gear or whatever. Okay, you guys, hope everybody's doing well. Today is the 28th, and we're all still here. So whether something's gonna happen, I don't know. A lot of the, I'm not gonna go into, I'll make a video about that later, you guys. I just wanted to get this out there because it was real quick and easy. So this is a good item throw in your guys' bag. Do it, it collapses very easily, and it weighs next to nothing, okay? Good item to have. Hope you guys are doing well. Thanks for views, subscriptions, positive feedback, friend advice, all that jazz, you guys. Thank you, I'm grateful, and hope everybody's doing fine. Take care. I hope this is useful for you, Danny, and all you guys out there. Pick it up. They're called Shemagh. They're not a do-rag. They're called Shemagh. And like I said, you can get them anyway. So take care, you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm going to go in depth about what I feel about the whole alignment, Elanin, that's now broken up. But take care, you guys. Love you. Thanks for the positive feedback and views. And I will see you in the next video. Take care. Okay, Disney, come here.